of the hills. Big four-wheel drive trip this time. We've got six of us in here. Probably introduce people throughout the trip. This is William, brother-in-law. Our aim is to try and find a stag, maybe a chamois, but just have a bit of fun and shoot some deer. So we're all splitting off into three groups this afternoon and go for mosey. Harry and Robbie have already set off, so they don't have any cameras. They'll probably shoot all the deer because that's how it goes. But nah, enjoy.
No, man, someone had a shit day. Nice steep start for the boys.
Nice steep start.
Here's the other half of it.
Look at that. Well done. That was sick.
Man, I'll just come home with something.
To what?
That's pretty sick. Yeah, sure. It's got the skinning hook on it too.
Yeah.
Love it.
Yeah, stopped for a leg break and put the binos out and two stags up there.
Pretty huntable where they are, right up on the skyline, so. Oh, f***ing good start. Worth a closer look.
Yeah. Good.
Both pretty much the exact same size.
Yeah. Reds, I guess.
One's got big, yeah, reds. One's got big grout hinds. Don't know if he's old, but. Oh shit.
It's a bit there, eh? It's not convinced that he's a monster, but.
No. It's alright.
His antler. Been up to these tops before and a couple of years ago and it was all good. It's like, yeah, I know where we're going. First of all, I've led us through a whole shitload of manuka we didn't go through last time and bluffed out twice, and
now we're coming up through this crap.
Sorry, William. Follow me, I said. Whoops.
Nothing like a bit of thick bush.
Sick. Where'd you find that?
Like a pier below my feet.
He's just a young tucker. Nice shape to him for a young dude. It's a real light green. Well, on the little spur that goes down it. He's just going uphill now, moving quite quick. Oh, he's chasing the hind. He's trying to fuck. Wait a minute, he is fucking. Sorry, buddy. She's not chuffed with that. You see him?
No, I can't see him.
In late July, what's going on there? God,
He's thirsty for it, eh?
He's come back out.
Yeah. It's like he's seen another hind. He's roaring. It's mid-July. What the fuck? I've never seen that.
He might not have figured out when the cycling head and he's just fucking horny.
Yeah.
Gotta do something to stay warm out here.
Yeah,
good spotting. Siamese deer here, it's got two heads.
Same spot.
No, neck's face back. It's a bit more antler in this one. He's got the right hooks.
Oh, that's it.
Yeah, that might be a pretty good sham, William.
So good.
Little shot.
Nice shot. There we go. We got a deer.
Perfect.
Nice.
But yeah, it's pretty epic up here. Seen a chamois, a couple of deer, and yeah, it's been an epic day out so far. About to get dark, so we're going to start bashing our way down through there. Good luck to us. It'll be about 3 hours before we're back at the hut. So we'll only be looking forward to some dinner, I'll tell you why. But let's rip into it.
Hey, good. Boys just come back. Knocked over a hind.
Yeah.
Beauty.
Happy days.
I think it was a deer on day one.
Yeah.
Yeah, I can see that down there.
Yeah,
it's
cool. Exactly.
Please call out.
It's a pretty nice morning, it's been raining. Now it's cleared up. There's a bit of clag around the tops, but positive thinking.
Figure it out, won't we?
Righto, it looks like we've got a hind up on the rock up there, ready for Robbie to give it the smackdown.
Beautiful.
No pressure.
Try to close the gap, eh? About 700 yards at the moment.
That was creeping in majorly.
Yeah, I know, I'm a bit worried about that.
So we've decided those deer probably don't go too far, so we've got some weather coming tonight. We're gonna make the most of the good stuff now and get up behind us for a look over the back, and if there's nothing there, we'll come back and have another crack at them.
Spiker. Two wee spikers. Well, they just might have smelt us then.
don't know. They both just lifted their heads and like simultaneously and looked in our direction. It was fucking weird.
Well, spent the morning making our way up this valley and hoping to hunt country out the back there, but Clag's coming in and she's forecasted to rain in an hour or two, so just gonna make our way slowly out the valley and hunt all the slips and hopefully pick up a deer or a shimmy. Cool country nonetheless.
You've sacked it, Robster. It's down.
Did you actually want to stand up on the rock?
No, yeah. One's sitting down. Do you, on the rock?
Yeah.
On the, yeah.
I
found
the left one.
Yeah. That, the, one there, so. Yeah, there's one in the clearing that was standing up. It's down though. You've got it.
Where is that one? Next to it though.
Yeah, the clearing just above it.
Oh.
Yeah, look on that rock, Harry. There's one that's gone down.
Yeah,
I hit wide. I don't know what, because it looked like you're aiming that way, so I had like both in frame, but. Yeah, it just stood up before.
Oh, the one in the clearing.
Yeah.
Oh, right, right.
Good shit, though.
Good shit.
Nice, boys.
That was a good spot. I wouldn't have taken one someday.
Yeah, because you were facing that one. I was like, fuck, is he aiming at that one?
I just look up in there and say,
yeah.
Rock. It sounded like a hit.
Yeah.
Nice, mate. Good shit.
Good job.
Easy as that. You guys like the f***ing A team, eh?
We don't muck around.
Yeah. I'm going to bring you guys out more, eh? Let you shoot something.
It's a pretty good stalk. Shot it down in the clearing below us. Harry set the gun up for me. All I have to do is pull the trigger. Here we are. Didn't even move, so great outcome.
Perfect. Bit of butchery now, then back down the hill before the weather comes.
Nice wrestling routine of Matt from NTN Gear, and he's given us two of these mountain bipods to try out. These things are bloody incredible, eh? For the last few years we've just been using packs to rest off, and these things, yeah, have just been a game changer. It really is crazy how much extra stability you have from these things. They tilt and swivel pretty much any way. They've got telescopic legs, so they can have different heights to suit your kind of environment. Attach super easy. They're really easy with this rail system they got. Just a click of a button and it slides on and off. Nice and lightweight. But yeah, so if you want one, check out MTM Gear. They have a range of different products. Mostly just have bipods and walking sticks / ice axe. So yeah, cheers Matt, awesome gear, we're loving it.
All right, boys all packed up. Heading back to camp now.
Happy days.
Gonna try a bit of a higher route. To cut out some river walking. You beauty.
Is that just water in that pot? I might just tip that in this to clean it.
Was companies driven back by this committed Warriors defence. Let's send it down to our man on the sideline, Matty Russell.
Thank you, Elon.
Unbelievable.
Shut up, Tony. That's the fucking wild, eh?
You can sleep well tonight, Matt.
Oh, Willie and I are gearing up for last morning hunt. I was talking to the camera, bro. gearing up for our last morning hunt. One last chance to stagger a chamois, but we'll probably be a little bit less picky today. And if we see a deer, I'd say we are, say William.
Yeah, if we see a deer, we'll nab it.
Bloody oath. And whilst we're out going for a hunt, the boys are in watching the fucking rugby.
He's got
to look for a knock-on from an Argentinian player.
Try Argentina. No shit. Good start, boys.
A hind and a yearling.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah. Can't say I've seen heaps of fresh sign down here either.
Yeah.
It's that winter sun, eh? Yeah. All these valleys just getting cold and frosty and.
Nah, no joy for me and William, but nah, hell of a trip anyway. If you're interested, know more about William, you probably noticed he's only got one leg. There's a hell of a story behind that, and he's written a book about it a couple of years ago now, but just every day is a good day for William Pike. He's a bit of an inspiration of William, so yeah, no, it's been a hell of a trip. It's been different, eh? Having Starlink on board, being able to watch live sport way out in the back country, it's felt weird. It was awesome, nice wee treat, but wouldn't want it to be an everyday occurrence.
Right, so Sunday morning, boys just packing up. Mitch and William have actually headed downstream on the quad bike to have one last chance at a deer, but the rest of us just been chilling here, watching the footy actually. You probably noticed we had some pretty cool toys this trip. We've had Wi-Fi at the hut, which has been a pretty weird feeling, but cool to have once in a while. And yeah, obviously had TV to be able to watch the league and the footy this morning, all thanks to Starlink behind us, which Tony has. Yeah, he's got some super cool toys, old Tony. He's on TrackMeNZ, he does everything kind of technology or tracking based anyway, sells in reaches, hires them out, he has a full network he provides. We all use him, we've been using him now for about 18 months, and he's just a lot more reliable than our last provider we've kind of found. I guess being local is just a bit better, and he's just a super knowledgeable guy and yeah, really insightful. So everyone, anything kind of tracking based, he does dog collars, PLBs, in reaches, power banks, does a whole lot. So yeah, if you want anything, go down and check out Tony. But yeah, cheers to all the gear, Tony. It's been a hell of a fun trip, and yeah, carry on packing up and head on down. So yeah, basically the plan is I'm going to traverse this range for a few days, just camping away along these tops, out here trying to find a nice summer chamois. epic. I thought I almost stuffed that up, to be honest. Right, so the boys just shoot. Fuck. Right, so the boys both gone up.
It's kind of like a yellow bush.
Yeah.
So go.
So you're thinking of that thing, aren't you?
I think so. In the middle, left of the frame. Right there.
Yeah, I think that's a bush.
There's two. Oh, it does look like a f.
Too big for me.
That's horrible. When you ready?
Oh, mine's all good.
No, you just walked past.
Didn't realise you were on camera, mate.
Sorry. Trying to be subtle. Not fuck you guys off too much.
Just packing up the hut. Got shit everywhere, so it's just fuck's sake.